Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of KigerCraft. I'm Tigorso, here with Kieran, and today I've got a couple things I want to show you before we get started on what we're going to do today. And this here, if you remember from our last episode, this is the entranceway into the main area where I want the entrance to my castle to be. I went through here, I've made a couple swatches. As you can see, I've got another brick over there, I've got some cobblestone and whatnot, but this here is the front of the mountain, or the hill right here. I removed all of the dirt. This was previously dirt. Everywhere you see stone bricks was dirt. And I left the smooth stone. I wanted it to kind of be, have like the natural look, because these structures are really awesome. I didn't change it all that much, but just trying to give you guys kind of an idea of what I've got thinking about, so you can give me your thoughts. How you guys think this looks? Does it look too rough? I mean, I think it looks pretty good. I'm a little bit hesitant on knowing what it would look like with the rest of this all done. So I'm a little unsure. But got a couple options for building materials. We've got the smooth stone, which I removed from this part. We've got the stone bricks, cobblestone, and nether bricks. Nether bricks seem to be too dark. I'm really leaning towards the stone bricks here. The cobblestone is a little light and very busy with all the gray and the white. This is much more darker, much more muted. And this is just, I think, too dark. Hopefully we're going to get some cracked stone bricks and mossy stone bricks soon, and maybe even some mossy cobblestone, so we'll see about that. But I just wanted to go over this with you guys, so you can let me know what you think. I think it looks pretty cool. Here's the other side. I did a little bit more going up this side. As you can see, there's lots of stone bricks. Lots of stone over here. This side over here, there's lots of dirt, so I think I'd have to terraform that a little bit before I did that side. But let me know what you guys think in the comments. So today, we are going on an adventure. We've got ourselves some ender eyes, and we are going to find a stronghold. Boop. Yay, this way. And the reason why we're looking for a stronghold is so that we can get to the end. Because yesterday, during his anniversary stream, Slantro sent a ton of you guys over here to our channel. He had almost 2,000 viewers, and he sent about 200 or so of you. So yesterday we had close to 100 subscribers, and we were getting ready to do a 100 subscriber special. We now have 190 subscribers. So we pretty much blew past that yesterday, and we are getting ready to do a 200 subscriber special. So look forward to that. Pretty much what we're thinking is we're going to have to kill the Ender Dragon. We want an Enderman farm, so we thought that that would be... Let's make sure we're going the right way. There we go. We thought that that would be a cool thing to do. Take all of our new subscribers and go kill the big baddie. And then that would open up the end to us, and we could do some pretty cool things with that. So that's what we're planning on doing. That's why we're going on an adventure today to find the nether portal. Or not nether portal, the end portal, rather. So yes, we want to welcome all of the new and... Oh, don't land in the tree. Oh, it broke. Damn. That sucks. Well, six more. We definitely want to welcome all the new subscribers. We really appreciate you guys being here and all the wonderful things you guys said. Somebody commented, was like, these guys only have 50 views? Yes, we don't get a whole lot of viewers, but the ones that we do have are awesome, and we appreciate all you guys. So we want to welcome you all to the channel. We hope that we are very entertaining and you enjoy watching our videos. So thank you for being here. So yes, do look forward to our subscriber special. It will be coming soon, hopefully, if we can find the portal. We're not going to give up until we find it, so let's keep on trucking. And since we have so many new people, some of you may not know who we are, so we'll just do a little bit of a reintroduction. Ooh, this is high up. I'm Tigorso. That's my name. I also have Giren here with us. And we are Kiger. That's the name that we have for things that we do together. So when you say Kiger LP and Kiger TV, that's the combined total of us. But my name is Tigorso, and Giren is my buddy. One other thing that somebody asked is that, will we be seeing Giren's place? Yes, we will be seeing Giren's place. Let's go ahead and get another test here when we get over here. Ooh, baddies. We will be seeing Giren's place in the next couple episodes. We're going to take an adventure over there. He's got some work that he wants to do on his place before we go see it. But we will be there. So you can look forward to that. I'm sure it'll be awesome. From what he tells me, he's got a pretty awesome place. Another episode, or another question somebody asked in the last episode was, will he ever talk? And the answer to that is no. Giren will not say anything. He doesn't like to talk. Oh, are you kidding me? Really? Got one out of that. Down to five. He won't talk. He's not going to. He will speak to you through text. He'll answer comments and things like that, but he's not going to ever say anything, so just so you guys know. And, oops. So many monsters. We actually, a lot of people are surprised at how good our videos are. We actually don't have any experience in doing videos or anything like that. We've actually never done any sort of video production or anything of the sort. So when people say that we do a really good job, that really makes us happy. We actually haven't even been Minecrafting all that long. Minecrafting. All that long. We've only been playing for about 3 months. We just were kind of sitting around bored one day, and we're trying to think of something we could play together. We're like, hey, what about that Minecraft thing? And we're like, oh, that sounds pretty fun. Let's try it out. And here we are. We liked it so much, we decided that, you know, to look around to see what other things were there. We stumbled across a bunch of Let's Players on YouTube, and we said, hey, that looks fun. Let's try it. And the rest is history. There we go. Make sure we're heading in the right direction. Oop, caught it. So yeah, we're having lots of fun. We really enjoy all the love that a lot of people have given us. Cilantro, Michael, and those guys, they're great guys. We love watching them. A lot of people made comments, you know, like, oh, Cilantro Army incoming. We always laugh whenever we see that because it's so much fun when Cilantro sends his army of people in to say hi to us. It makes us feel good. But actually, it's not the first time he's done that. He's actually plugged us several times. He's a real great guy, and he's sent his people to our channel. He sent them to our live stream. One time, it actually caused my internet connection to go down because he sent so many people my way all at once. Everything kind of just went boop, offline, and it took me a while to come back, but it was great fun. I really appreciate everything that he does for us. He's a real awesome guy. So is Michael. We like both those guys. And we were in his 1 year anniversary stream, which was totally awesome. So many awesome people coming by. Notch being the most famous one, I think. That was really cool. I was like, really? Is that the Notch? I thought it was a troll at first. But then he was like, nope, that's the real Notch. And I was like, wow, that's cool. And then there were people like, I saw Paws and Paws, Etho was there, Who else? There's somebody else that I wanted to mention that I'm forgetting. Oh, Man vs. Game was there. So many other people. It was just so awesome. And to watch him do the latest Super Hostile map, waking up, was a lot of fun because we've tried our hand at Super Hostile maps and we failed miserably. It was just an absolute disaster. So to watch him, to watch somebody who's actually good at it do it, it was quite impressive. So that was lots of fun. So we had a great time with that. A lot of you probably aren't going to be familiar with us unless you watched our first episode about this world. This world is a new world, well, semi-new. We've been playing it for a couple weeks. Ever since we started our videos, we started the brand new world. We were recording when we logged in for the very first time, and we just started going from there. We've got our first sort of hub project done, which was the treehouse. Oh, this is interesting. Oh, this is very cool. Wow. See, this is why when I was looking for a place, I really wanted extreme hills, because look at this. The structure is amazing. Wow. Huh. But this is a new world. The treehouse that some of you might have seen is kind of our first project. We made a little hidey hole to keep us safe for the time being. But the treehouse was the first project that we built on camera. Well, mostly on camera. So that is our central hub, so to speak. That's where we keep all of our inventory and supplies, and that's where our main nether portal is, so we can easily travel between our places, our new places, which we just started off at my new place, and the central kind of hub, the treehouse. So that is definitely our pride and joy. The treehouse was the very first thing that we built in this place, and we like it very, very much. It actually turned out pretty good. It's still kind of unfinished. There's still a couple cosmetic things that I need to do, like putting vines on the outside and converting everything over to the new 1.3 textures for like half-colored half slabs and different sorts of things like that. So I will be working on that occasionally, but that's not our main focus right now because it's essentially done. The rest of the stuff is just cosmetic. All right, let's see. Where are we going now? Off that away. Oh, we're going to need some dirt. There we go. Just break our way over here. And this is all new terrain generation, as you can see. One of the cool things that I noticed with terrain generation is that if you're in an old spot that was previously generated, you will not see things like these. But if you're in a new generation, since 1.3, you will actually notice that the jungle trees will have the cocoa plants on them. The old trees that were generated will not. That's just something that I noticed walking through our old jungle, is that there was a certain part of it on the back where I generated a new chunk and the trees had the cocoa plants on them. So I thought that was pretty cool. I don't necessarily know if that's true or not, but that just seemed to me like what it looked like. So, cool thing. So we are in new terrain right now. We've never been out this far. So hopefully we will find our stronghold soon. Would like to get it done during this episode, but if it runs too long, we'll just have to do it off camera. So let's go ahead and give us a test. Yep, we're heading in the right direction. Oh, darn. Down to 3. All right. Up, up. There we go. So, exciting news today. Everybody's been waiting for it, and it's finally here. It's August 1st. Well, probably go up on August 2nd, but 1.3 is here. Yay! It actually was updated to 1.3.1, and so there have been a couple bug fixes, but essentially the game is the same. We are still having the problem where we're generating, we're logging into the nether, so to speak, and falling through the world. It's happened a few times, and a couple disasters have occurred, but thankfully, make sure that we don't really have a whole lot on us if, in case that does happen. The new ender chests are amazing for that, because we have an ender chest back at the treehouse, and we got an ender chest at my place, and Garen's got one at his, so we can just put our expensive stuff in the ender chest when we log into the nether, so that way if we happen to die, fall into lava or something, we don't have to worry about all of our stuff getting lost. So that's really nifty. Ender chests are already super useful. So that's something very exciting. A lot of people have been asking about live streams. Let's see if we can fix this. Oh, it updated. Oh well. We don't really have a set live stream schedule. We just kind of do it whenever. It's really hard on my computer, and it does create a lot of lag for some people. And that's one of the things that's really holding us back. My computer is very old and not upgradable. I've already punched about everything out of this thing that I possibly can get. So some people have suggested we should ask for like donations to get like a new computer so we can do more Let's Plays and things like that. I'm not really sure how I feel about that. We're a new channel, and I think asking people to, you know, donate is kind of premature. So I don't really think that we're going to be doing that. But people have been asking for, you know, more videos and, you know, more streams and things like that. But unfortunately, you know, due to our limitation, it takes us about, I want to say about 6 hours. No, it's longer than that. It's more like 8 hours to render and upload an entire episode. The rendering takes an extremely long time. It takes us about 2 to 3 times as long as, let's go ahead and, takes, oh, did it go back? Or have we just wandered that far? Let's see. Ooh, maybe we're close. This should be exciting. But it does take us quite a long time to render, because we do like doing the high quality stuff. We don't want to compromise on quality, so we take the time to render things in the nice HD with all the nice sharpness and all the goodness that you guys like. Crap. Hopefully we're getting close here soon. We're running out of ender eyes. So if somehow we happen to, you know, get a new computer, we will probably be able to do things quicker because it won't take us as long, but I'm not really sure about donations and things like that. If I happen to be just like wrong and you guys would be open to that, I guess I would consider it. Oh, it's raining. No. If you guys are, do think it's a... Whoa! Did they change the sound on that? I'm getting all distracted here now. You know, if I'm wrong, you know, leave us a comment and let us know that you guys would be open to that, and I guess I would consider it. But this isn't about money. This has never been about money. This is about fun and interacting with the community and things like that. Oh! Got it. So we love you guys. You guys have been great to us. We really appreciate you guys being here and all the great things you do say. So let's see here. I'm actually kind of excited because I think we're actually really close here. Is it here? Where'd it go? Oh, All right, it looks like we are actually really close. Let's check this out. See if we can't find something here. Whoa. What the hell was that? Did you get hit? Huh. I wonder if it's... No, it's not because I'm hungry. You know, I have been... I did hear that there was a glitch where if you stood in blocks, like if you stood against a block, like in a corner or something like that, sometimes you would get pushed into the block and you would take some suffocation damage. That may be what that was. Ooh, we got a cave. Is it... Looks like it's just a cave. Let's light this up a bit. See what we got going on here. Really close. Here's spiders. Ugh. Interesting. Well, okay, well, we're gonna expand this out a little bit, go through this cave, see what we can find. But one of the things that you guys will notice, hello zombie, is we have another series that we do every so often, which is the Binding of Isaac. We're probably not gonna be doing that anymore. It's a little difficult to do, so it's not terribly popular, so we're probably not going to do that one from now on. We're probably going to focus just mainly on Minecraft, because that's what you guys are here for, it's what you guys like. So it's definitely something that we want to focus on. Let's see what's got all open surfaces around here. I'll light this up. There's tons of minerals in here, tons of coal. I don't think I've ever seen a cave with that much coal in such a small distance. Getting massive frame rate drops, but what I'm gonna do, since we're not gonna be doing Binding of Isaac anymore, is I'm gonna roll the things that I did, the newsly bits, into the Minecraft. So it's gonna be like kind of a new portion that I'll do, and the newsly bits is pretty much what I do as I go out and I find cool things that interest me in science and awesomeness. There's lots of skeletons down here. And we try and I make comments about them and things like that. And it's lots of fun. I enjoy it and get you guys newsed up. Yeah, I see you shooting at me. Hey, jerk. Ow. But there's some really cool stuff going on in the virtual reality sphere. There's this new headset. I actually just heard about it, which is the Oculus VR headset. It's got a lot of big names who have said that this thing is actually really cool. Gabe Newell, John Carmack, lots of really big names. They have a Kickstarter that they started today, and they've already blown past their goal by double. They originally had a goal of $250,000 raised for Kickstarter, and their last time I checked, it was $500,000. So there's a lot of people out there who are really interested in a really immersive experience. Ooh, a mineshaft. Looks like Garen's been working down here already. I'll go ahead and seal this up a bit. Keep any baddies away. So that's really cool. I, for one, have really been interested in virtual reality. It's just never really been any good. And that's what they say in their little Kickstarter video. If you guys get a chance, I definitely recommend that you go watch it, because it was actually really cool. Or they talk about how they've developed their development and why they started this and whatnot. So some very cool things. So maybe in the future... There. What? That's weird. So maybe in the future, you know, we'll all be playing our games with virtual reality headsets, which I think would be really cool. Because virtual reality headsets is something that, you know, it's that sort of future thing that they've always promised, but it's like flying cars, it never got here. So that's definitely something I'm looking forward to, and I'm sure you guys are as well, because it will be awesome, and I suggest you go to Kickstarter and check it out. Watch their video. It'll be really interesting. Ooh. Bread. Got tons of rails already. All right, I don't want to get too lost in here. Because I'm bad at getting lost. No, actually, I'm not bad at getting lost. I'm actually really good at getting lost. But definitely cool. Also, people have heard me talk about, and we've discussed this in the live stream before, about computers and processors and things. I've always built Intel machines, but I've never had an AMD machine, but I've always tried to consider them. And it's always, Intel has always won out, unfortunately. Let's see what Garen's got going on here. But some exciting news today is that AMD has brought on the architecture designer for their old Athlon K8 processor, which was actually a really good processor. So I'm excited. I really want some healthy competition between AMD and Intel. You know, I want them to fight for my money. I don't want to just be like, oh yeah, well, you know, Intel's the best and, you know, blah, blah, blah. You know, I want there to be like, well, you could do this. Here are the pros and cons. Both of them are really good choices. That's what I'm looking for. So hopefully, gonna release it. So hopefully in the future, we will actually get some of that sort of competition going, and that would be really fun. And then lastly, but not least, earlier we spoke about how Notch was in Cilantro's stream. One of the things that we discussed a few weeks ago was about how Gabe Newell thought that Windows 8 was a disaster, and now Notch has added his voice to the chorus of people who are concerned about Windows 8. Though actually today they announced that it officially was released to manufacturing, and in October is when it will become available to the general public. But Notch is concerned about what the Windows App Store is going to mean for indie developers, which is definitely something that, you know, we should all be concerned about, because indie developers right now, in my opinion, are driving the innovation of a lot of games. You know, we've got Binding of Isaac, we've got Minecraft, we've got so many different things, and, you know, because the normal games have just been kind of stagnant. You know, you've been having your Maddens and your Battlefields and whatnot, and nothing has really changed all that much. So new gameplay options are definitely going to be awesome. So we seem to have run into a little bit of a circle. Do we have any Ender Eyes left? So we're out of Ender Eyes. So we're going to start digging around here, see if we can find it. This has been a pretty long episode for us, but we definitely are excited to have everybody here. Welcome everybody to the channel. And we're going to dig around here, find out where that place is, and we're hopefully next time we'll kill the Ender Dragon. So keep your eyes peeled for that. I know, exciting. And we will see you guys next time. Take care.